From the Library of Congress in Washington, D.C.
Brother Dubinsky, I find it somehow significant that this year marks the 50th anniversary of the birth of your union and the 100th anniversary of the birth of Samuel Gompers. President Dubinsky, the motion picture of your union with these hands portraying the struggles and accomplishments of the ladies' garment workers also typifies the struggles and accomplishments of the American labor movement. Samuel Gompers was the architect and builder of the trade union movement in this country. He came to America as an immigrant boy from the east side of London and bound up his life and destiny with the millions of underprivileged. Many of the scenes shown in this picture would have been familiar to President Gompers. I know he would have been proud, as we are, had he lived to see what American labor has achieved for the wage earners as well as for America itself. Your union is to be congratulated for this fine film. This is a film not only for the International Lady Garment Workers Union or the labor movement. This is for America and for a free, democratic world.
Coming from you, President Green, this is indeed a high tribute to our union and to our membership.
Thank you very much.
Your name, please?
Alexander Brody.
What is your occupation, please?
Cloak operator.
Age?
65.
When did you join the union?
1910. January 1910.
You must be glad to retire. Sign there, please.
Between now 1910, a whole lifetime. How many millions of seams can two hands sew in 40 years? How many thousands of garments? 1910, the world we lived in.
Hey!
1910. The world we lived in.
Not so much material. Please, put a garment on a figure. How long are you going to be in the cloak business? There. DeLeo, you broke yesterday 2 needles. 50 cents fine.
2 needles cost a penny.
One more word, the fine will be $1.
$1 is a whole day's wages.
For the last time, 10 for your bundles. Or else, wrap up your machine on your back and go work somewhere else.
You're not the Tsar of Russia. You're only a boss.
Shut up.
I'll talk. I go to night school. The teacher writes on the blackboard, a free land. Sure, it's a free land, all over. Except 14 hours a day in the shop here, it's not a free land. DeLeo, 50 cent fine. Brody, no talking.
That's all. You're through.
You should have thought of your family.
I'm not a worm, I'm human.
When the landlord comes for the rent, I'll tell him Brody's a human being.
I did right, Jenny.
I owe it the butcher.
He'll trust us.
Who else is going to trust us? You better go look for another job.
I'm going to a union meeting.
They've been talking union for 30 years. Talk. Barrandis, Grossman, John Deitch. It's all talk.
Yesterday after work, I heard Meyer London speak. He said, in this industry, the survival of the fittest is the survival of the meanest. There's only one thing. Strike.
You can't. You hear me? You can't strike.
55,000 cloakmakers struck. We had stood for everything we could. A year earlier, in 1909, 20,000 shirtwaist makers had struck, women and girls. What they could do, we could do.
If the most hot summer since 1900, we go on strike. Okay?
For 58 days, we marched on the picket line. 58 days.
My feet, all the time they hurt.
In the summer of 1910, lots of things hurt.
Your husband should have thought of it before he went on strike. When you make the payment, I'll bring back the table.
Ma.
This is how you finance a strike. The last things you have left in the world. You finance a strike with the things you love. With Jenny's wedding ring. With the watch that Mike DeLeo's father gave him in Italy.
Thank you. What'd you expect? Mustard?
Please. Yeah, schlemiel.
We don't accept bribes.
Two pretzels for a penny, that's bribes?
If you no got a penny, it's a bribe.
Lunatics. Here, I can't see people should starve.
We don't want charity. We want what's right.
What?
Union.
Newspapers never know how to write about a strike. A strike is torn shoes and no meat on the table. A strike is Jenny without a wedding ring on her finger, but a tight ring of fear around her heart. Hurts to be on strike. Maybe it hurts the machines and the cloth too. But a machine is only a tool. Doesn't get hungry. Yet cloth was made to be cut, and the machine was made to sew. And the good worker hates to see his hands idle and his machine quiet. After 58 days of quiet, we won union recognition. A floor to stand on, a foundation on which to build. You build a union not just with contracts or wage clauses or working conditions. You build a union with men and women. Everybody knew why the Leo coughed. Pain for long hours, for days and nights without fresh air, for bad food. He coughed at night so that we could hear him from our flat.
Like your new shoes?
Yes.
Let's try them. They're a little big, but you'll grow into them. What do you give for them?
A hug.
So give. You know what happened?
You paid the rent.
That's right, I paid the rent. And what else?
Mama doesn't have to sneak in the back way anymore.
Mama don't have to sneak in the back way anymore. That's right. Here. Here's some licorice. Wonderful. Take a bite. Good? You break your teeth, huh? You want to take another piece? Go ahead. Good?
Leo. Leo. Look, DeLeo, you don't have to come to shop meetings. Now, why don't you go home and go to sleep?
I no sleep.
Can I get you a glass of water?
I don't want to break up the meeting.
Part of the reason for this union is people like DeLeo. The bosses think that when we fight for a union, we're bargaining for more money. We're bargaining for DeLeo's life. There ought to be laws. There ought to be laws to help workers. Maybe the only way to get laws like that is to make them ourselves by electing our own people to public office. Yeah, and the only way to do that is to take the elections out of the hands of these ward healers and put them right back where they belong, in the votes of the people. People like us.
How's it going?
How's it going? As it always goes.
Hey, Joe. Where are we holding the celebration tonight?
At the hall.
What celebration?
The victory celebration.
What victory? Who won?
Oh, Fletcher 212, Costello 309, Hillquit 40 votes.
40? You mean 440?
Hillquit 40 votes.
Hillquit's pile is bigger than the Singer building. I counted it myself. 440.
40 votes.
440.
40 votes.
I demand a recount. I demand a recount!
Mm-hmm.
he's alive.
Oh, my head. What happened?
You're a hero. DeLeo just went down to the shop. They're cutting you a medal out of cheesecloth.
He knocked me down?
Naturally. They brought you home in a wheelbarrow.
I swear, Jenny, we had the votes.
Doesn't depend on who has the votes. Depends on who counts them.
Just wait. Next year.
Please God, if times are good and we can afford it, next year they'll carry you home in a horse and wagon. Next year they'll count you out again.
Maybe.
You'll get knocked down again.
Maybe.
Like a dope, you'll get up again.
Yeah.
All right. Then it isn't hopeless. If you're knocked down and you insist on getting up, I guess maybe it isn't hopeless. Your face is dirty.
And where do you think you are going?
Just out for a minute.
What for?
I don't have to say. I just...
You are lying. You are going out to talk to a union organizer. I pay you to work. Nobody goes away from her machine. Every window stays closed. Every door stays closed. Go back to your machine. No union organizers for you, girlie. Not on your life.
March 25th, 1911. Triangle Waste Company. Doors locked from outside, windows tightly closed.
...146 dead. Dead immigrants. And the dead children of immigrants. There are the dead martyrs... ...and there are the martyrs not yet dead. One dies by fire, one dies by disease.
What are you, an Eskimo?
Fresh air.
This you learned from your books, huh?
From Brody.
I should have known.
That's soup.
Chicken soup.
It's with the spaghetti.
With noodles. It's the same thing.
It's very good soup, Jenny.
You haven't tasted it.
It's very good. It's a good soup, Jenny. I waited to cool off.
You didn't have to go to the funeral.
Brody went.
Brody doesn't cough.
It's for respect.
You didn't have to march behind the hearses. You didn't have to march all the way to the Williamsburg Bridge.
40,000 people, they march. Not the Leo.
You coughed all night.
It was a very big funeral.
What good does a funeral do?
It's to protest.
That doesn't bring them back to life?
No. But now 40,000 people, they know their names. The dead have names. It's their immortality.
Drink your soup while it's hot.
Yeah. Who are these women? These children who die in a triangle fire. Did I know that? Would I go to the funeral? The whole world is a go to the funeral. And now because they die is already to be a new law. A door is to be open in a factory. A window is not to be locked. And because it was said to them, no union. Now thousands are come and they join the union. 40,000 people, they march. It's a respect.
Tomorrow, you'll go with Brody to the doctor. Hmm?
Janet. You're so practical.
It's chicken. What are you studying? Don't you recognize a chicken?
Brody's right. When a poor man gets a chicken, one of them is sick. The man or a chicken.
You can put your things on now. Are you a relative?
No. A friend. I work at the next machine.
Is there hope?
A small chance. If he leaves the shop and is taken immediately to a sanatorium.
DeLeo hasn't got two nickels to rub together.
He doesn't need any money.
The union?
We'll send him to a sanatorium for as long as... for as long as it takes.
I'll tell him. I guess maybe we're a new style in unions, huh?
Maybe.
Here, let me do it.
I was listening.
What's Italian for schlemiel?
Schlemiel.
That's Italian?
It's a clockmaker Italian, eh?
Lots of new styles, eh? All right. You'll go away and sit on your behind and drink good milk and breathe fresh air. You'll come back new style de Leo. We'll see.
Per me, si va nella città dolente. Per me, si va tra la perduta gente.
That's me. La perduta gente. The lost people.
That's old-fashioned stuff. You'll be so strong when you come back. So fast. Even your collar will fit you.
When he went, it made a difference. Many things were different. Changing like fashions. My daughter's coat, 1916. My coat, 1918. I went to France. I ate beans. I learned about cooties and homesickness. Then I came home. Time passed. How do I know? How does any garment worker know? A hemline gets shorter. 1 year scallops, next year fringes. 1 year a sweatshop. Then, thanks to President Schlesinger's fight, a shop like this. In the 20s, there were new styles in politics as well as in women's clothes. Paris sent over its latest creations, and so did Moscow.
What is it this time?
Don't be so bourgeois. I'm only trying to read the weather report.
Fair and warmer. Wall Street propaganda.
In the Soviet Union, there's no unemployment.
In fascist Italy, there's no unemployment.
No comparison.
Sure there is. Both have a low peace rate and a high debt rate.
Brody, you're the chief enemy of the working class.
Sure. I'm a reactionary. You always voted for Eugene V. Debs.
Social reformer. Capitalism must go to ruin. Let it go to ruin. Make it go to ruin. Depression, unemployment, starvation. Lenin has given us our slogan. The worse, the better. Improvements? Reforms? Better working conditions? No. Revolution. You, Brody, and the leaders of this union who sell the workers out to Wall Street. Betrayers.
Trump.
That's all finished. We're taking over.
We demand a 50% wage increase.
They won the workers over with fantastic demands.
All power to the shop councils.
Their whole strategy was to make it impossible for the employers to yield.
Strike. Strike.
The strategy was to force
strike.
A crisis.
Strike. 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 Strike.
We wanted to build the union. They wanted to use the union to build a communist party. So they forced the general strike of 1926. To a man like President Sigmund, it was like a sentence of death. They wanted to take power. The only one who took power was the electric company. They shut off the current. The Union Treasury wiped out during 28 weeks of political strife. The Union we had built, bankrupt. Sure. What's a union? A letterhead. An office. Then why did it hurt so much? The strike? We crawled back to our jobs. It hurt. Then, in 1929, the whole world began to hurt. This was the time for which the Union should have been ready. The time when the Union should have been strongest. It was left a hollow, bankrupt shell, owing $2 million. 10 cent milk we couldn't afford to buy. Depression? Yes,
depression.
The only thing we have to fear is fear itself.
He was the turning point in the life of America and in the life of the Union. NRA, the Blue Eagle. There was a code now, a code of fair practices.
With every passing month, we are making strides in the orderly handling of the relationship between employees and employers. Conditions differ, of course, in almost every part of the country and in almost every industry.
Section 7A, we didn't know it, but it was going to write a new history of American labor and the ILGWU.
When you were just a business agent, you say hello to a fella. Now you're head of organization, drive stock up.
Mike DeLeo. I'm glad to see you. Here, have a seat.
No time to sit. I'm arrested.
Arrested? I'll call our lawyer.
No, arrested TB. Pretty bum joke, eh?
Excuse me, Mike, I'm a little busy right now.
Yes, I read about injustice, that's why I'm here.
I don't get you.
I read the union just hired 100 new organizers. Shake hands with organizer 101.
We're not just organizing New York and Chicago, Mike. We're going into the little towns of Pennsylvania, New Jersey, the South, Texas, the Midwest.
Any place you want to send me.
I'm sorry, Mike. It's not for you. It's a hard job. It's dangerous work.
Look, I just come from the most dangerous work a man can do, staying alive. I can tell the kids in Pennsylvania, New Jersey, what a union is. I know. Look, you can't fire me. I'm volunteer.
Volunteers like Mike DeLeo rang doorbells in Milwaukee and Hazleton, Pennsylvania. Paid organizers manned sound trucks in Easton and Minneapolis. Everybody welcome. In 111 cities from Dallas to Winnipeg, from New Haven to San Francisco, new faces, a growing union, from 40,000 to 80,000, from 80,000 to 150,000, from 150,000 to 200,000 to 250,000.
With the bosses. Bosses.
Oh, Alec, you're home.
The pool room was closed.
Where have you been?
At the shoemaker's. How can a man wear out a pair of shoes in 2 weeks?
It's very simple. Help the dressmakers picket non-union shops before work, lunch hour, after work, in 2 hours on Saturday.
You're not so young anymore. Leave the picketing to the younger dressmakers.
Listen, I'm a veteran of 1910. When it comes to picketing...
My father's a veteran of the Kishinev pogrom. He never stops talking about it either.
I married a contractor.
Off the couch with your feet. Where do you think you are, Unity House?
I just made the last payment. Now I can't put my feet on the couch.
Not in my house. Be an example to your grandchildren. Off.
Oh. Here's my wages. This ought to keep you quiet.
Off, off, off. Come on.
Woman, don't disturb me. I'm reading the financial report of the International Ladies Garment Workers Union. Oh. AFL, USA. Receipts, disbursements, international assets.
Come on, there's a dollar missing from the pay envelope.
Donations and relief. The horses I don't play.
$1, give.
Organization.
Jenny, a man isn't made of wood, after all.
$1. I want it.
It was an assessment. We're helping to organize the steel workers and the auto workers.
Last month, it was an assessment for the miners.
I have news. Next month, there'll be an assessment for the textile workers' drive.
Who are you working for, me or the labor movement?
How many suits or dresses does a family of a textile worker buy on $15 a week?
Don't change the subject.
Through the union, you raise wages, you improve conditions. People live like people instead of like an apple. Does an apple buy what I make in the shop? No. This stuff about the American standard of living, you know how you get it? Build the trade union movement.
You should have gone to night school. You could have been a lawyer.
The Bar Association. That's a union. The American Medical Association. Talk about a closed shop. They wouldn't even let a doctor in it.
Alexander Brody?
Who knows? Maybe it's good for the stomach. Settling peace rates with the boss, thanks to the union, was always easier than settling anything with Jenny. Dispute under collective agreement. Strike? No. The boss calls a representative of the employer association, and we call the shop business agent. $2. When Jenny said no, it was no. When the employer and the association says no, it goes to an impartial adjuster. $1, $2. Trouble. When the lower court is in trouble, what do? You go to the Supreme Court. Instead of 9 judges in black robes, 1 impartial chairman. Chosen by the union and the employers. This is collective bargaining. You give a little, you take a little. $1, $2, you work it out. All right, $1.75. Collective bargaining. In 1910, because we wanted to be people, we went on strike. And now, today, what people can do. Hands that can take cloth and needle and thread and make a living thing. Such hands can take a canvas and paint and clay and also make a living thing. The union protects the bread you eat. There are many kinds of bread. A book is bread, and the singing is bread. And this too is bread.
I want the class to bear in mind that in the future, the union will increasingly emphasize our welfare demands. Pensions, sickness insurance, vacations with pay.
And what is a vacation with pay for? And what is Unity House for? June, July, August, September.
Ah.
smell the air. Smell it.
I'll smell it. I'll smell it. You satisfied?
You're scaring the fish.
Who's scaring the fish now?
I see a flower in the water.
Congratulations.
You know what kind of flower it is?
Flowers? What do I know about flowers? I'm a cloak maker, not a milliner.
This is where Jenny and I have come each June or August. The days of our rest. A healing from work and trouble. Still a time comes when there is need for another kind of healing. You come to a place like this. You see the concrete and the steel, but you remember Mike DeLeo Coffin. You remember the first Union Health Center, the overworked doctor. And you say to yourself, it's better now. Now, it's almost a pledge of life. For now, there are many Union Health Centers. Boston and Philadelphia and St. Louis in 11 cities across America. I think sometimes that only those who remember 1909 and 1910 can know how far we have come. Only we can measure the years.
Well, for an old-timer, you'll do.
What do you mean, old-timer? During the war, I gave blood to the Red Cross 10 times. All right, 4 times. But my blood? but sometimes, Doctor, gas pains. Jenny's cooking, eh?
Arteriosclerosis.
It's nothing to worry about. It's what growing old means. When I get to be your age, I'll settle for your heart and your arteries. But slow down a little.
Slow down a little. Mm-hmm. All right, I'll cut out pinochle.
Play pinochle as much as you want to. You might start thinking of retiring.
Me?
You know that the union has a retirement fund. Let's see. 1910 to now.
I think you deserve a pension.
Think it over.
Bye, Doctor.
Bye.
Thank you. Arterial sclerosis.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing for you to worry about, huh? Goodbye, Doctor. You're home?
The pool room was closed. In the closet.
What?
What do you mean, what? After 38 years of hearing it every day, you should take it for granted. I mean, put your hat in the closet.
Oh. Jenny.
Mm-hmm.
This Social Security. How much is it paid by the month?
You got fired.
Don't be a child. A boss gets fired, not a cloak maker. Oh.
Something you ate, huh? Oh, why must you buy hamburger in a cafeteria? You can never go wrong with cream cheese.
When you accomplish your purpose, I'll eat cream cheese.
What purpose?
The ulcer you're preparing for me. Your shoes off the couch, your hat in the closet, wipe your feet on the mat, wash out the ring from the bathtub. What am I, a baby?
No, you're not a baby. You're my husband, my good provider.
Getting old.
The machine goes faster and the hands go slower.
Every time you come from the doctor, you feel sorry for yourself. Look, if you're worrying about me, don't. The union also has death benefits.
I said it before, and I say it again. You have the soul of a contractor.
You're such a dope. A man with grandchildren. We'll get along. With the retirement fund, plus Social Security, and with what we have in the bank, we'll make out.
These are the men and women who inherit the Union, which was born in 1900 and which grew out of the sacrifices and the pain of those who went before them. 400,000 members, skilled workers, loyal trade unionists, good Americans. They have built a union and an industry. Garments for the women and children of our country. These are the things our hands have made. Hands. Hands to tell a story. Hands that have built a way of life.
Mr. Brody.
Huh?
That's all there is to it. There won't be any trouble or delay. You're practically on your pension right now. Here's your union book.
Thank you.
You're very welcome.
Goodbye. A new member?
Yes.
Your first book?
Mm-hmm.
My last. A simple cardboard folder. Something to hold your due stamps. But it's more than that. It's a way to go. A good way.
This has been a presentation of the Library of Congress. Visit us at loc.gov.